Hello guys, you are welcome to the channel History Nerd JRF Classes. Today in this video, I am going to deal 15 MCQs on Vedic Age, and Vedic Age is very important for the NET exam. Those who are watching the video for the first time, please go subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon. So here we start. The first question is, in which of the following books of Rig Veda Samhita, Eastern and Western Oceans are mentioned? Options are Book 1, Book 7, Book 9 and the last option is Book 10. So basically this Book 10 is going to be the answer, and Book 10 is very important. Lots of things are being mentioned in this book and those questions are always asked. So whatever information, whatever bit you get on Book 10, you should know that and try to build a better understanding on Book 10 of Rig Veda, like why it is so important. The next question we have, which of the following books of Rig Veda Samhita are also known as family books? Book 1, Book 8, Book 9, Book 7. The answer is Book 7. Basically, family books are Book 2 to Book 7, okay? So, all the books from 2 to 7 are called family books, and the reason is all these books are attributed to some rishi, seer, muni, okay? So, that is the only reason for these books to be known as family books. Next question is, how many hymns are addressed to Usha, the goddess of dawn? It is important, you should remember this, you might have MCQs. So the options are 10, 15, 20, 25. The answer is going to be 20. Only 20 hymns are addressed to her. The next question is, Brahmana text of Rig Veda is Atre, Jaimine, Gopath, Shatpath. The answer is Atre. Basically, Rig Veda has two Brahmana texts. One is Atre, fine. The other one is Kaushitki. So remember these two Brahman texts of Rig Veda. Next question is, the Rig Veda has mentioned Panchjan, a group of five tribes. Which of the following doesn't belong to the Panchjan? Options are Yadu, Puru, Vishani, Anu. So the answer is going to be Vishani. Vishani doesn't belong to this a group of five tribes, and this Panchjana is very important in Rig Vedic text. Next question is, the battle of 10 kings is mentioned in which text? Book 1, Book 5, Book 7, Book 10. So the battle of 10 kings is mentioned in Book 7. There is one more battle that is being mentioned in Vedic literature, and that is battle of 20 kings, and this battle of 20 kings is mentioned in Book 1. So don't get confused in the exam. Basically in Vedic text there are mention of two battles. One is battle of 10 kings, that is being mentioned in Book 7, that is family book, and battle of 20 kings is mentioned in Book 1, which is not a family book, and they are being included in later Vedic literature. Next question is, one of the epithet of God Indra was Gomath, Janase Gopa, Gopati, Gojit. So that epithet of God Indra was Gopati. Gopati means lord of cattle. So he is given this epithet of lord of cattle. The next question is, word for plough in Rig Veda Samhita is or are? Phala, Langala, Sira, all. The answer is all. All these three words are being mentioned in Rig Veda Samhita in the context of plough. The next question is, the earliest reference of division of society into four strata is mentioned in Prushukt Hymn, Book 10 of Rig Veda Samhita, Family Books of Rig Veda Samhita, Book both A and B. So this division of society into four strata, that is basically in later Vedic period constitute Brahmana, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. So it is basically mentioned in these two, like in Book 10 of Rig Veda Samhita in Prushukt Hymn. So the answer is going to be D, both A and B. Next question is, how many types of marriages are referred in Rig Veda? Okay. Options are monogamy, polygamy, polyandry, polygamy. It's all these marriages are being mentioned in Rig Veda. That means at that time even polyandry was in practice. Okay, so don't get confused with the MCQs, with the options. You should, like, Rig Veda has a different society. Today we don't have this custom of polyandry in India, at least. The next question is, The earliest reference to iron has been mentioned in the later Vedic literature. Which one is that? So the iron is being mentioned in which later Vedic literature? Options are Samved, Yajurved, Atharva, both B and C. Answer is both B and C. And remember this like Ya, okay? This Ya, Yajur and Atharva, they have description about iron. The word being used is Krishna, Shyama, Shyama S, like this. The next question is, Vansha Nartin, pole dancer or acrobat, is mentioned in which of the following text? Options are Samved, Yajurved, Atharved, both B and C. So the Vansha Nartin is basically mentioned in Yajurved, and you can remember this with this small trick that Vansha, okay, it's V for Vansha, then just draw a stick, then it become Y, then it become Yajur, and then V, Veda, Yajurveda. Next question is, the word Nagara is used in the sense of town is mentioned in which text? Jaimini Arnayak, Taittiriya Arnayak, Chandogya Arnayak, Shatpath Brahman. So the word Nagara is used in the sense of town and it is being mentioned in Taittiriya Arnayak. And it is an important question that basically Rigvedic society is being or Vedic society is being mentioned as dominantly a village settlement society, but here we have reference to town. So it is very striking actually. So the next question is, which of the following cereals are mentioned in Rig Veda? Barley, Godhuma, wheat, Vrihi rice. So only this one is being mentioned in Rig Veda. The next question is, which one of the following cereals are mentioned in later Vedic text? Yava, Godhuma, Vrihi, rice. Then actually all these three cereals are being mentioned in later Vedic text. So answer is going to be all. So guys, this was for today. I hope you will enjoy while solving the MCQs. The PDF link to the MCQ is given in the description box. So go and download and share it with your friend. Please like my video, share it and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.